All right, lucky viewers, we have Claudio Esposito here. He's fresh from Italy. He's in a three Michelin star restaurant. And tonight he's going to show us a wonderful classic, the gnocchi. Please, take it away. Can I help you with anything?
Yes, I need the two saucepans. One large to make the sauce.
Yes.
No problems.
Excellent.
Now, I need the olive oil.
Olive oil, do you like it strong olive oil or light?
Strong. Doesn't matter. Olive oil is olive oil anyway.
Yep, we're catering to a party of 12 to 15 guests.
On the stove, one corner, put it in here anyway.
Okay.
We put the water for the potato there. Now, I need a blender for the onion. It's on.
You want it very hot?
Has to be hot. A blender for the onion. Spoon. Wooden spoon.
You'll find, George, check that one. Here's one.
This one is better.
If done well, the gnocchi isn't as bad as most people consider in terms of its carb content. He emphasizes to me how important it is to make it fluffy, and obviously the more air in there, the less carb. So we've got the onions frying, the crushed onions frying now, and I believe we're going to need this.
Later.
Yeah.
Cooking salt in it. Mixer in it. Mincemeat. Where's the mincemeat? And the pork ribs.
Interesting little addition he's got here, pork ribs, to give it more substance and flavor. It's something most chefs don't use in the gnocchi, but some opt for anchovies, some perhaps chili, but the depth you get with a different fat gives you some nice flavor, I'm sure.
It is.
Looking forward to it indeed. Pork spare ribs.
In the meantime, if you can get a large saucepan to boil the water for the potato. Cover up with water. Salt.
Just so you know, we've added 3 kilos of potatoes. As I mentioned before, the gnocchi is a very festive dish and he's quite accustomed to cooking it in large quantities. 3 kilos of potato, and we've got 7 tins times 400, almost 3 liters of chopped tomato tins.
See, normally I mince my own meat, see?
Mm-hmm.
I buy bulk.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
What cut of
top side.
Oh, top side.
Yeah.
It's good, it's got a nice high fat content. That's what the flavor is. Let's be honest. All the flavors in the fats, isn't it?
Yeah, that's why I put the pork ribs in.
Shut up, mate.
Just put the cold water in there. Because they have to take about an hour and a quarter.
You want cold water in there?
Yeah. You can't use that thing, that's it.
No, we have a blender here that should do the job.
Yeah.
Oh, might have to.
You put 6 in it.
Mm-hmm.
And leave the 7 one out.
Okay.
Thank you. You can pull straight in.
Oh, can I?
Yeah.
It's three. Ooh. Whoa.
That's it.
That's enough for a banquet.
It is. When I used to cook, it was good for 16 people.
16, you say? Oh.
16, they're all family, see?
Mm. And why didn't we crush the last tin, may I ask?
Huh?
Why didn't you crush this one for texture?
It got a bit of a tomato in it.
Yeah, texture. It's,
because you don't want it bubbles all the time, you want it smooth.
We have a shit kicker here. Where did he go? Where's that shit kicker gone?
No,
David, I think his name was.
Yeah.
He's working for $3 an hour, would you believe it?
I believe anything.
Dave! So what do you usually do? Do you freeze the gnocchi and the sauce separately?
See, when I got the tray,
yes,
they are about that size.
Yeah, I use them too, yes.
About half a meter by 300-350. I put flails on the bottom of the tray, mm-hmm, and I put the fresh gnocchi in it.
Mm-hmm.
Then I put flails on top of the gnocchi, and I can add the tray identical to cover up, and I put it in the freezer.
Right.
And they stay there for 2-3 days. Then I'll take them out, and I split them, because they stick together sometimes. Mm-hmm. I split one at a time out, mm-hmm, and I put it in a glass bread bag.
Yeah.
And I store it in the freezer. Right. And when I need it, just boil the water with the salt in it. Just boil the water, put in 2-3 different, not too many at a time. When they come on the top, I let it boil for a couple of minutes.
Mm-hmm.
See, the gnocchi got the white flail and the potato. It looks like it inside still green.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, not cooked.
Yeah.
Until it all come white. They all come white, they...
And then you know.
Oh, they're beautiful.
But don't you, doesn't the gnocchi get hard if you freeze it? Like when you make it, from what I understand,
no, that's
it's soft. No. Because you put the flour bed.
Because the flour, nothing to do with the flour bed. It's the way they're made. See, one egg. Italian people used to put 3 or 4 eggs in it. Eggs is glue.
Mm-hmm.
And they use a different potato.
Right.
And what they did, they come just like a bullet, no gnocchi.
All right.
When you go to a restaurant, you eat flour, because they take a lot of flour to...
I know, I hate it.
I put the less flour as possible.
Well, I understand you make it fluffy, but I just thought maybe if you freeze it, it loses.
No. They stay as they were.
Really?
They stay as they were. Identical to that.
Well, that's great.
As a matter of fact, when they're ready, you're going to boil a bit of water, mm-hmm, and you just boil it, and you put fresh in it.
Yeah, well, I'm expecting to eat some before we freeze it today. Don't you worry, Claudio.
That's what it is, eh? The only thing, see, the sauce is very important. It's important, you have to always, my father used to cook the same as my mother. The same ingredient was different.
Really?
Because you have to look after the food. See, sometimes cook on one side and won't cook on the other side.
Mm-hmm.
And you have to always stir a bit.
I see, of course. And when you've got such big volumes like this. Yeah,
yeah, well, see, I'm not doing every, I do once every month.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody come along and eat.
Saw me standing alone without a dream in my heart, without a love of my own. Blue moon, you knew just what I was there for. You heard me saying a prayer for someone I really could care for.
They squashed it in and mm-hmm, flails on top.
Yeah, we've peeled the potatoes, we've got it all ready, three kilos of potatoes.
Yes, we put a bit of flour on top of it, about 3 tablespoons olive oil, and now a bit of salt.
In Dad's case, a lot of salt.
Yeah.
No. An egg, one plain eggs.
And he tells me it's very important. Other people might be using 3 for this quantity of potato, but he says the egg is like a glue and it shouldn't be 2.
And now you,
gluey,
you just
gently fold it in.
That's the worst part of it.
So we had a bit of flour. We've squeezed out the potatoes on top of the bed, then some flour on top. And he generally goes by feel when it comes to the texture here. He doesn't really, because the potatoes can vary in the amount of moisture they've got, so you really should rely on your feel more than specific volumes. So I read the Queen Elizabeth has literally said your gnocchi was the best she's ever tasted in 1987, I think.
Something like that.
Very good. We're going to be eating royal gnocchi. He made a trip to England back in 87 on special assignment. He just won a national cooking award and he cooked for Queen Elizabeth. This very same dish.
More flour. That'll do it. Stick to your finger and you keep on
gently folding it.
Take a while until it blends in anyway.
Oh, you can see it's forming a dough. And it could. What happens if you, for example, if you accidentally add too much flour to this and it becomes too dry? Can you add moisture into it somehow to save it?
Nope, no. So you have to use your judgment.
So you've got to do it right.
Yep. I think there's a little bit over 3 kilos there, but anyway, doesn't matter. We soon find out when they're ready, you're going to boil about a dozen and you'll find out.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, when the work to be done, if you saw. I'm sorry.
Don't worry, you can say what you like. I can take it out. So you just say whatever's on your mind.
That's the worst part of it, you know, really. You know?
Mm. But it's important, obviously.
It is.
Very important to do it.
See, everything worked in properly. See, normally the tables are lower than your shoulder.
And you can use your weight.
Yeah.
Mm.
See, it's not much flavor in it.
Mm. Do you remember the first time you did this?
Yep.
Where was it?
Oh, my wife used to do before me, see?
Mm-hmm.
When she got crooked, I started to do myself.
Mm-hmm.
My desk comes from a person who used to live in the same place in Trieste.
In Trieste.
Yeah, she was marvelous cook.
And who taught your wife?
She did.
She taught herself?
No, this woman, which I grew up together with her.
Mm-hmm.
My wife met her in 1960, she met her and she learned to cook out of her.
Remarkable, you look at the texture, it doesn't look doughy and it's still, yeah, it's still dry yet seems to have elasticity.
If you want to feel it, if you want to do a bit, you can.
Oh, I would like to feel it, yeah.
I wash my hand because.
And it's warm.
Yeah, oh yeah, potatoes hot.
It's just separated in flour.
Just squash it then. Squash the spread it. You won't hurt it. But sometimes, unless you do it yourself.
Yeah, it can be done. But I'm getting a good understanding of the texture. It's not very doughy. It's more potatoey texture.
Yeah. All right, off you go.
Thank you for that, chef.
You see, the point is that you have to really like that.
Really need it. Right.
Only thing that we won't have enough try. You know?
What do you mean?
Yeah, look what's going on here.
Yes.
Yeah.
So they're like 2 centimeters.
Now, squares. Would you like to put a dish of boiling waters on it?
Yeah, sure.
See what I do? A bit of salt in the water, please.
The meat off the pork is coming off the bone?
Yep.
So you cook it like pasta, yeah?
No, less pasta, 25 minutes sometimes.
Yeah, and this one?
Couple of minutes. Because already cooked, everything is cooked.
No.
There's only the flour.
Looks good.
That looks all right anyway. Feel all right in the hand too. If you give me a plate,
yes.
I'm gonna put some in it. Ready when the water boils, you can put them.
Cook now?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
So this is being prepared to freeze.
Yeah.
Yep.
That's what I do. I put another plain shell on top of it and I freeze them.
Okay.
And you can use it in 6 months time.
Oh, you can take one off at a time too.
Yeah, one pack, one bag at a time.
And you assure me it's just as good as. Fresh, yeah?
As says make the as you eat now, they'll be in 6 months time.
Oh, that's fantastic.
When the water boils, you just put them in the water.
Mm-hmm.
When they come all up, clean, that's ready.
That's ready, okay.
That's what I mean, that's what he does.
Yeah, because he wants to taste it. That's fine. But that's
no, he wants the meat.
That's next day. A bit more salt, eh?
Well, it's up to you. So, you can always put it in. You can't take it out.
That's for David. Just to make sure it's going well. That was there before. Don't blame me.
Possible.
Bullshit.
You know why? Because he put the board on there instead of put the white dish first.
Oh, it was there before I started, okay?
Oh, yeah.
Saucepan on.
Is the water boiling there?
Not just yet. An hour and a half.
No. Well, that's one of them. Can you pass me the flour, please? The flour, is it? That's what I normally do.
And sprinkle with flour so it doesn't stick to the tray, yeah?
No, no, it doesn't stick to each other. Really. And then I put another tray on top of it,
mm-hmm.
A flat tray.
Oh, I see.
That's what I said, a square flat tray, see? That's it, you can put it in the freezer, that's it. Have a look what I mean by the center cook. You see, when they come up, you see that in the middle?
Yeah.
It's still glassy a bit.
Yeah.
Have to be all white.
Oh, like al dente.
No, well, the flare has to be cooked.
So did I say father with the chef from the 3 Michelin star restaurant in Tuscany? You know if someone that's from here? Yeah, he's from Tuscany, Claudio.
Is he here still? Is he there?
No, he's back. God. We were lucky to get in for the 2 hours to make this gnocchi.
Oh, okay.
Thank you, Claudio.
Are you going to send it to
him? He's going to get it for the rest of his life, so I'll see it on YouTube.
Oh,
the
kids will.
Oh,
it's beautiful.
It's not gnocchi, it's marshmallow. Did we put the marshmallow in this sauce? Because there was nothing in there.
Your dad is not talking. Oh, Anna, what do you think?
That's great. We won't have to wash that plate.
Oh my god.
This one's got a vinegar.
It's amazing.
It's beautiful.
How do you get a texture like that?
Well, you have to watch the video to know that.
Yeah, 1 egg and the ripe potato. And a hell of a lot of love.
It's unbelievable. I only had the gnocchi
twice in my life before, and I hated it because
it's so doughy and
it's so
heavy
and I'm heavy.
Amazing.
There's
too much
flour. I don't
know if that's someone's wife telling me that. I don't know.
Any good girls?
Or if she's going to get lunch tonight.
When the moon hits your eyes like a big pizza pie, that's amore. Girls, you want seconds? Come here.
You have to tell girls if they're on Instagram.
Amazingness. You know
hey,
what
Jared,
the number
just try to leave a little bit for Lauren.
Hashtag in the world.
Otherwise she'll kill us.
Sorry?
There you go. 36
million photos have been uploaded
on
one hashtag. And that hashtag, the most
prolific
hashtag in the world right now, is food porn.
Is what? Food porn. You didn't
need the
first part, did you?
No, but seriously, when you upload a photo of some like great food, like plate, you just search food porn. Online, 36 million photos.
Oh, God.
It's the number one hashtag.
Photos? So I am, not followers, photos.
No, photos that people have uploaded. And now I'm going to contribute to this.
Isn't it
crazy?
Yes. Seriously. Right, it's a waste of time.
No,
it's not. These people get to pay $5,000 just to put
just
one post
up. Just put one photo up. $5,000.
The company will say, can you put my photo up on your account? I'll give you $5,000.
Absolutely. We do it every day.
So, yeah, because they built up the followers.
Yeah, because I see a photo of someone wearing something, talking about something. This is how I know about my legendary girlfriend. Because people taking photos of the coffee and the food and they upload it and you're like, oh, yeah.
But you could have just asked me. And
yeah, but you just stumbled. You have stumbled across it.
And what is wrong with that? Nothing. I don't think it was.
But isn't it amazing if you shape someone else's weekend? If you post something and someone says, wow, I'm going there. So you actually influence someone else's life.
Well, they don't have a life.
No. But then it's like you actually have an agenda. Like, I have a list, so I'm like, okay, cool, this is where I have to go.
Because someone else said it was really good.
There's a million other restaurants you could run to.
It's hundreds of
thousands. But because you went to this, you got someone you can trust.
That's right.
What? Yeah, stranger on the end of a hashtag.
Not just one person.
But they haven't let you down.
But
they haven't let you down.
The beauty of the hashtag though, it's not just one person. Because you can't just trust one person. That would be like literally thousands of people. And if they say it's good, it's like a, you know, a statistically correct sample, statistically valid sample.
No, I think that's great, but if you're sort of in and out of which one should I go to, mm-hmm. some of the things are great.
Yeah, well, I don't want to ruin my Saturday. And I'll be pissed, and I'll make a fucking note on my place, Foursquare or something. This place is horrible, the lady with the red hair doesn't know how to serve us. Now, we read that in Warm yesterday, so we didn't go to that restaurant.
Okay, so what about that that place that me and you went to?
That's a brothel, Dave!
And the coffee was shit. It was cold, and we walked out, right? Mm-hmm. That was supposed to be one of the best coffees in Melbourne. It was shit.
Which one's that?
Yeah,
remember that?
And now they're not in the top 10 anymore.
No,
St.
Okay.
Are you talking about St. Helens?
No, some place, yeah.
St. Helens.
They're in the top 5 in Melbourne. Like, top five in Melbourne. Like, I drank the coffee and I thought, it's shit, gentlemen. You told them it was shit. And we didn't
like that.
They didn't even charge us.
This is the case study. That's what ruined St. Helens. The reviews, the social media outrage over their overpriced, overrated coffee.
And they're not in the top 10 anymore.
And now they're not there. Because there was such an outcry. That
and they didn't charge us. So, it all pays off.
You guys went to a coffee shop.
Even though the lady said, geez, you're the most good looking person I've seen this year. I said, I don't care. I don't like your coffee, bitch.
Is that what you said?
Yeah, that's what happened.
Now you're eating this little shocking coffee. Little terrible coffee. Probably the worst coffee I've had in Melbourne.
And who recommended this place to you guys?
Don't you?
Did you think it's good information? I take it on. So it was good? It's not good. So what is she
going to say tonight? They're too busy. I've seen celebrities there all the time. A beautiful song. But they lost it.
This is made out of potato, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah. 70% potato.
And flour.
You just leave some for Lauren, so you tell me, I don't know how much you have.
Fish eyes and
oxtails. No, they don't
like enjoy that. Damon gave us the present of the ox tongue without telling us, and we didn't enjoy it.
They did enjoy it until they learned.
No, we didn't actually enjoy it at the time, but we were not in order.
You can say that now. How can I prove you wrong?
No, but we're all sitting there going, very fun, Mingy.
You didn't say no, honey.
No one spat it out till they learned.
Well, I suppose we're guilty, aren't we?
You didn't say no.
Look, Cameron, he's having some parmesan cheese with his gnocchi.
No, some cheese.
In New Zealand, he has his pasta dish, and he bakes it and basically leaves the container with it. Mm.
She made it, it was my idea to have fresh colour.
See, like, they take photos like this, this is what they pay for. So, like, just take photos like that. There's 1,300 people like
this. What is that?
What is it?
Just a little close up of clothing and things.
Are you serious? You can't even tell whether it's a good piece of clothing or not.
Yeah, but you gotta remember, they pay $50,000 for an ad on TV. I want to send your people out.
But that was half a shoe!
You wouldn't believe it. Like, we have absolutely with no uncertainty demonstrated that the moment that woman, EJ Maxwell, put something of ours online, as a whole thing, we sell out. Like, that's why it's worth paying.
It's just
great marketing.
It is just
That's all social media marketing.
Human beings are sheep. Really sheep.
The sheep,
yeah, but they've always been sheep. They used to be trusting to
But our job is not to correct human beings. Exactly. It is to make as much money so I can have a good weekend. I don't give a fuck what the humans do. They're doing this and I'm tapping into it.
Shoes sold out.
What shoes? I can't even see where the shoe is on.
Well, it's a good thing because if you like them, you can't buy them.
You know, you're for marketing, honey. And I give up.
That's
there's a quarter of a shoe hanging out. Mm. There's a handbag. There was
and then they say, oh my god, I want the shoe, where they're from. And then she says, it's from Target Australia. And then people are like, oh my god, how much are they? And she says, $20. So it's not us talking
about the
the person talks about Rome. And you get 100 of them, what we call influencers, combined, getting a million reach.
That's
million
why I hate
women
marketing. It is so
out there. But it's like Jalen, he'll say, if you're looking for something, he'll Google it, right? Now, I won't Google shit, I don't even know nothing.
I'll let you Google stuff.
And now you've got a backlog thing, half the price of anything else.
A third of the price.
And we went for a little drive.
I'm on a long drive on my back and went through Holden's. Every time we drive with Jarman, he's always wrong, and I'm always wrong. doesn't matter what it is. Is that my
you can't know that because it didn't go the other way. So we've got to take his word for it, but technically Jarman's wrong. Have you Googled my ass, Dave?
From this angle, it's pretty shitty. Literally.
Oh, bullshit, I forgot to wire the
thing. Don't you use your little thing? What's it called? Okay.
It's called Kirby's tongue.
That camera's still rolling.
Yeah, it's 20 minutes.
That's just not on.
You leave the editing to me, thank you very much.
I bet.
Do you want to put the parmesan on top, Dave?
No, she won't have
it. Is that on target?
Yes, to make magic happen. Are you sure?
I'm going to
fix
these.
When you put them together, it's been more than just
100 cents. And when there's a new person.
They're much more than that. So, singing Avicii's Hey Brother tonight, this is Brothers 3.
Yeah, here's Lauren, don't forget her.
Okay.
No, they didn't want it.